I think part of the reason why I sound so unenthused when I do these things is because I do them like at 4 in the morning. I'm like half asleep.
I have a message.
Hello, Victoria. This is Todd. I heard about the 5th murder. I expect a full report on my desk tomorrow morning.
Yes, you would, wouldn't you?
My god, her boss sounds like a chode. That's cool. Next. Okay, and anything else we can do? Nope. Let's talk to this kid.
Why did you take so long getting here? You're the only one with a 4x4.
Christ, I don't even want to go there. I mean, what is it with these idiots who buy 20 lottery tickets anyway? I mean, do they really have to waste everyone's time? God, they piss me off. I just wanted a pack of gum, too. Hey, last time I saw you, you were limping to your car. Are you okay?
Yeah, I'm fine. It's just my ego. It got hurt more than me, I think.
I don't think you have an ego.
So what are you up to?
I started the report. I figured you were too pooped to do it.
You know, Miller, you do have your moments. Anything I can do to help with the report?
Actually, yes. I need Claire's preliminary report to help me out. I'm not going down there. She might lock me up in one of the drawers and leave me there. Also, I need the pictures you took, so could you please drop the camera in the evidence chute in the hallway?
Oh, I almost forgot. Is everything okay with your girlfriend?
Oh yeah, forget about it. She knows now it's a big misunderstanding. But just don't answer my cell phone again, please.
I promise. Well, okay, see you later.
Well, besides that, Miller's girlfriend probably knows he's a pussy, so she wouldn't really cheat on her. Alright, onward. Now that that's done.
Agent McPherson.
Officer Tate?
Agent Ashby wants us to...
All right.
Me and some of the forensic guys set up a lab...
Oh, well, I hope no one got...
Nope, I know what y'all mean, though. That place was as stable as lemmings near a cliff.
Which one was it? Let's try door number one. And I picked the wrong one. It's wonderful. Puzzle right here. And it's simple. Look at this. Turn it around. Vodka. You first have to select it, run it through here. B O D A. A. Okay.
Hey Claire, got that preliminary lab work done?
As a matter of fact, I'm not quite finished. However, I have enough to brief you on if you have the time.
For you? Always.
Okay, here goes. The victim's blood revealed high levels of alcohol. Also, I found traces of Rohypnol, which is also known as the date rape drug. This explains why there was no apparent struggle throughout the assault.
Okay.
The assault started in the first room where she was beaten. She probably fell when you found the spot of blood. She was then carried into the next room. The killer ripped off her clothes and beat her again. She definitely was unconscious at this point. He let her bleed on the floor until he had enough blood to write the messages you found using the luminol. The killer then cleaned off the messages. Obviously, he knew we would find them. He then dragged the victim by her hair along the hallway and stopped to hang up his coat. He finally brought her into the bathroom. The cause of death was drowning. He forced her head under the water until death ensued. Like the other victims, she was killed before the mutilations. She was stabbed 9 times and then eviscerated from the lower sternum to the lower abdomen.
What are you thinking?
I'm thinking these mutilations will get worse. It wasn't part of his MO for the first 3 victims. They were found beaten and drowned, not like this.
Do you think he'll change his MO in the near future?
No, I don't think so. Drowning his victims seems to be his focus. That stage in the assault is very important to him. No, the stabbing business is from something else. I have a feeling that if we knew what it was, we would catch the son of a bitch. Also, he covered the face of the 4th victim and now this one. This strongly suggests that he knew the last 2 victims. I'll ask Miller to correlate the last 2 victims' info. How about you? Did you come up with anything interesting?
Yes, I got a partial that doesn't belong to the victim.
Very nice. Did you compare it to the partial you found from the 4th crime scene?
No, not yet, but I'll let you know if I can compare them. After all, they are only partials.
What about the stuff I found? Anything worth mentioning?
We know that our killer has black hair, if it was he that hung his coat on the nail. It might have been a junkie for all we know, but it doesn't matter. We can use the hair for DNA comparison and place him at the scene of the crime. I sent the fibers to the FBI labs to see if they can find anything unusual or unique about them.
I've been meaning to ask you, did you call her?
Call? Oh, no, I didn't. I just don't have the courage. Can we not talk about this now?
Sure, but promise me that you will call her.
Okay, I promise.
Okay, sweetie, I'm out of here.
Don't forget my beautifully handwritten report. It's on the table.
Wunderbar. I'm gonna pick this up. Get out the door. Then we're going to give it to the guy from Beverly Hills Cop.
Hello?
Hi, sweetheart.
Hey, Dad.
I just heard on the news. Another one?
Yes, another one.
Is everything okay with you?
I'm okay. I'm just really tired of this case. It's going nowhere fast. I hate this passiveness. I think it's starting to get the better of me.
Well, before that actually happens, why don't you come here and rest? A little R&R won't do you any harm. You can use the jacuzzi to relax and put your thoughts in order. And it's almost Christmas. I have a little gift for you.
Oh, really? Well, I have the gift you wanted. Are you sure you want it? It seems a little ordinary.
Hey, it's what I wanted. So, are you coming to the house?
Yeah, sure.
Okay, honey. I'll see you soon.
Dad?
Yes, honey?
Thanks.
You're more than welcome. See you in a bit.
Bye.
Jingle bells, Batman smells, Robin laid an egg. The Batmobile broke a wheel, and the Joker got away. It's 4 in the morning, I don't want to wake up. everybody else in this house if I freaking starts yelling out, "Away!" Anyways, onwards.
Yes, I... No, well... Yes, I know!
Here's Claire's report. Hey, Miller, one last thing. Can you correlate the data of the fourth victim and the fifth to see if we're overlooking something?
Sure. I'll run them through the database. Thanks for the report.
Yes, I... No, well... Yes, I know, but...